we know in our heads that it is only God that saves. We know that it is only God that is righteous. We know that God loves us, God cares about us, God has redeemed us through Jesus Christ. We know of God's plan throughout history that involves David, where through David he's going to build his house forever. We know all of these things. We know about God. We know about God's goodness. We sing about it. You are good, good. Over and over we sing it. We know it, but we forget it because we're spiritual squirrel monkeys. We know that God is righteous and we're called to live for Him, and He is the one who is going to one day make everything right. One day He is going to make everything right. We know it, we forget it. We don't believe it because we're spiritual squirrel monkeys. It is only God that makes things right. It is only God that saves. And our only response to all of this, all the time, every day, is complete and total surrender. And what I love about David, what I love about this story, is that we go from a moment where David is bowing down in front of the man who is trying to kill him with 3,000 people, and he's saying, I trust God more than winning. I want to do the right thing, and I want to live for God more than winning, more than my feelings, more than my justice, more than what I think's right. The only thing that I care about is God. The only thing I care about is His rightness. So I'm going to lay my life down in front of you, Saul, and I'm going to declare these things. And then he forgets. He forgets. And he goes and he starts trying to do what he wants to do. That is us. Now, here's the beautiful thing about this. David is still a man after God's own heart. You hear what I'm saying? David's imperfection does not make him less of a human being. It makes him human. He's a squirrel monkey just like us. And he needs things in his life. What we see in this passage are three amazing examples of faith. The first one we see is this servant who is bold enough to go and to speak truth into somebody's life. Hey, Abigail, our worthless leader is going to lead us down this path and is going to wipe us out. Somebody ought to do something. David's been good. David's been right. What are you going to do? That took guts. The first example of faith that we see is somebody willing to say the hard thing, be bold in their truth. The second example of faith that we see is Abigail. Abigail went and could have lost everything. It was a lose-lose for her. She could stay with the ball and get wiped out. She could go to David, and David could keep on trucking on that horse. She's gone. Let's go kill everybody. Oh, look, a date. Some figs. Thanks. Like, that could have happened. Abigail was willing to risk everything as an example of faith. The last example that we see, of faith is someone to admit that they are wrong. Someone who's willing to repent. Somebody who's willing to change their thoughts and their actions and their lives to honor God. David. One of the things that I love about David as I look at his story, I look at everything that he does, is he messes up a lot. He's going to mess up a lot. He's going to sound a lot like us by the time this is over with. One of the things that makes him a man after God's own heart is that when he messes up, he owns it.